Hello everyone and welcome to PSE Programming using CODESYS YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to briefly present you one of the course projects that three of my students have done for the industrial automation course. So the project is called Automated Parking System Simulation. It's done by Camila, Rihat and Sanjar, the robotics and mechatronics engineering undergraduate students at Nazarbayev University. First, I'm going to demonstrate the project to you, and then I will explain you different components that we have in the project. So they have assumed that there are 5 parking spaces in a shopping mall, for example, where the cars can enter into the parking if there's any spot available. So initially we have 5 spots available. At the time of the entrance, there is a camera which reads the plate number, and then the number of available slots will be updated. So for the camera, they are simulating it by a text field in which we enter the text, like SEA01, for example, is what we get from the camera. Then if we press on the enter, the car will enter into the parking and it will be kind of randomly placed in one spot. Now the number of the slots is reduced to 4. They are taking care of the time in which the car with this plate number has entered into the parking, and therefore at the time in which it wants to get out of the parking, there will be the parking ticket issued for the car. So right now I can press on the exit button with the same plate number. The car will exit, and here we have the cost calculated for the car. Then we can have cars with different plate numbers entering into the parking, like SEA2, SEA03. If you have 5 cars already entered, then the parking will become full. Now there is no spot available. The parking full pilot light is turned on, the parking available pilot light is turned off. We can have the cars going out of the parking, and for each one again there will be the parking ticket displayed. So let's take car number 2, SEA02. You can see that its spot now is empty and we have now one available slot. Car number 3, we can take it out and you can see that the cost is calculated and is displayed for that car. And similarly, we can do it for the others. So basically, this is the way in which the parking system is going to work. We assume that there are sensors which check the entrance and exit of the car, and also we have a camera which provides us this plate number. We have also these 2 pilot lights to determine that we have any free slot available in the parking or whether the parking is completely full. And furthermore, they also have this earthquake sensor which basically resets everything. So once it is pressed, all the cars will disappear, they will leave the parking, we will have 5 slots available. Alright, so now let me start to explain parts of the code that we have here. I can start with the visualization. This is the main visualization that we have. The components are placed here. You can see that for each one of the switches here, they have assigned a variable. So this is entry sensor. For the second one, it's the exit sensor. For earthquake, it is earthquake. And then for the parking available and parking full, similarly, these are the Boolean variables. As for the slots available, we have the text list here with this variable, integer variable, which is assigned to PSC_PRG.available. We see how it is updated. And as for the camera, we have the string variable associated. The text variable associated with that is the plate. Here we have another text field for which we have the text variable, again plate associated. And at the lower part, we have another field in which the price is the integer variable which is considered for that. This earthquake is just an image which is uploaded into the image pool. So they have an image pool where they have uploaded this symbol and they are using it in the visualization. And also for the car itself that they are using is drawn here. So we have this as a car drawing visualization, and they have inserted from the current project car drawing. They have basically just have taken and inserted into the main visualization. Then for each one of these available cars, we can see that there is the variable associated with the or considered for the visibility. So available is in the form of an array in the global variable list. They are referring to the index 0, then here index 1, 2, 3 and 4. Depending on the value that we have here, these cars will be visible, will be made visible or invisible. Similarly for the string, they are referring to the plates array, which is an array of the strings. The plates is a global variable, which is an array of string. Then the available is an array of booleans. Time entry is an array of date and time. And we have these two RTC and counter up down variables as well. Then we can have a look at the main code. The main program PSC underline PRG that we have for this project is done in the CFC, in continuous function chart. It's kind of not too complicated. As you can see here, we have the RTC block used, which is used in order to specify the amount of the time in which each car has been in the parking. Here we have the enter callback function block that we are referring to. As you can see here, enter underline callback. There is the exit underline callback, quake underline callback, and the up down counter used here. So basically you can have a look at this and you can try also to replicate it. I'm not going into the details. And in the upper part, you can see the variables which are declared for the main part of the code. Let's quickly have a look at the enter callback. We start with this if statement. If enabled, then this part of the code will be executed. Then we have the exit callback. The exit callback is also developed in ST. Similarly, they have the main if then end if here, and inside it there is this for loop. Then another if statement, determining value for the global variable available with this index position. They are making it false, meaning that the corresponding car has moved out of that position. Here also the elapsed time is determined for that car at this position, and the cost is calculated for that car. And finally, we have the quake callback. In the quake callback, simply what they do is that they set the available variables components into false, meaning that all the spots are available, and as a result in the visualization you can see that there is no car in any of the spots. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed watching this and you have got some idea for your course project, hopefully. Okay, thank you for watching and see you next time in another video. Late bye for now.